Welcome to our Power BI tutorial. Today, we will create a report, using SWOT analysis data, of a telecom company named XCOM. Link to the source data, is placed in the comments below. So let's start the tutorial. Okay guys, today we will create a dashboard, or report, in Power BI desktop. And the data that we will use, is an MS Excel spreadsheet. And this is basically a SWOT analysis of a telecom company. Here we have the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats, and their impact. If we don't work on these items, then this is the expected cost we have to bear in future. Then we have the funds required to work on these items, if we want to avoid the expected losses in future. Then we have the estimates of benefits that can be acquired if we are successful on working on these items. Then we have the progress we have made on each item in percentage. For example, we have made 97% progress on skilled workforce. These are the funds we have already spent. While our budgeted spending is given in the next column. Against this progress. And finally we have the variance analysis of actual and budgeted spending. So, first of all, we will add a text box to our dashboard. We will use this text box as a title for our dashboard. Our telecom company is called XCOM. And these are the SWOT analysis of XCOM. Then we will increase the font size of this title to 32. We can also make this text bold to look more prominent. It is always a good idea to enable the snap to grid option. This makes the resizing and repositioning of your visuals very easy and precise. Now we will import our data into the Power BI. Because we have our data in MS Excel file. Therefore we will choose Excel workbook from Get Data. Or directly from the toolbar. Then we will just open our desired file. It will take some time to connect to the file. This is the navigator window. It displays all the tables available in source file. Here we will select the required table. Now, if we don't want to make any changes, we will press the load button. And, if you want to make changes, you have to click on the transform data button. However, because we do not want to make any changes, we will just click on the load button. Let the loading process finish. It will take some time. When the data is loaded, it is displayed on the right side, in the data pane. This is the table, and all the fields are also here. Using these fields, you can add various visuals to your report. First of all, we will add a pie chart, or a dollar chart, to our board. We will add the impact field to the legend area of the pie chart. And the description field will be added to the values area. This will display the number of items in the SWOT analysis. This chart will display the number of items by impact. These are the items having low impact. Then we have the items with medium impact and high impact. Then we will go to its properties. And in general, we will change its width to 427. because the total width is 1280. There will add two more charts here, making total three charts. Let's close the filters. Now we will copy the same chart we just created, and paste it here. From this chart, we will remove the description field. And we will add the expected losses field, to the values area. Now this chart explains, what is the real impact of low impact items, in term of currency, instead of counts. And high impact items, which in terms of count, are low, but here in terms of currency, they are significant. Similarly, the total impact of medium impact items, is around 247 million. After this, we will again make a copy of this chart, and paste here onto our dashboard. And we will remove the impact field, from the legend area of this chart. Then we will replace this field, with the category field. Now we can see the impact of SWOT items, by their category. This is the impact of opportunities, strengths, threats, and weaknesses. Now we will add a decomposition tree to our report, which shows us breakup of various items. We will add the expected losses field, to the analyze area, of the decomposition tree. And in the explained by area, we will add the category field, and the description field. In the chart there is a plus sign, which we will click to expand, by category. And then we will expand category, by description. And this is how we will see the breakup of expected losses, by opportunities, strengths, threats, and weaknesses. And then, the breakup of whatever item has been selected in the category area will be displayed here. And when you click here twice, the information in charts will be updated accordingly. Now, we will add a bar chart. And in this bar chart, we will add the impact field on the y-axis. And progress field, on the x-axis. And we will change the progress, to average. After this, we will add a column chart. Where, we will add the description field, to the x-axis. Then we will add the variance field, to the y-axis. And we will add the impact field, to the legend area. This chart shows us the difference between the actual and the budgeted costs. And these colors reflect the low, medium, and high impact of SWOT items. Because we have mostly discussed impact on this page, therefore let's rename this page to impact. And then, we will add another page to our report. And on this page, first of all, we will copy the title from the previous page and paste it here. On this page, we will add a bar chart. And on this bar chart, we will add the description field to the y-axis. And we will add the expected losses to the x-axis. and we will add the impact field to the legend area. Then we will make a copy of this chart. Place the impact field with the category field. These two charts are basically providing item-wise insight of expected losses. Let's change the name of this page to losses and create another page. And just like before, we will copy the title from previous page to the newly created page. On this page, we will analyze funds and their variance. So, let's add a bar chart visual here. We will add the description field to the y-axis. Then, add the funds required to the x-axis. And also the funds spent to the same x-axis. Change the chart type to clustered chart, so that we can compare both items. Let's place this chart on the left side of the dashboard. After this, to take a bird's eye view of the same chart, we will remove description from this chart, from the y-axis, and add categories instead. Place the chart up here, on the top right corner. We can change it to a column chart. Finally, we will make a copy of this chart, and place it below here. Now, we will remove all the existing fields from this chart, and we will add variance to the y-axis and the description field to the x-axis. We will rename this page to Variance. And that's it. Our report is now complete. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.